So I could have I could my talk could have had the title "In Habinit, we like analytical formula more than finite differences." it's more a status of work than to show what are the ongoing work in Habinit concerning the exchange correlation functionals, and it gathered several contributions from Jean-Baptiste and Luca and myself. We are all three in the same lab. So I want to present two, if I have time, two main things. One is a missing feature in Habinit that we try to implement, and the other one is something new and more advanced. So the first part of my talk will be about meta-GGA and PAW, and the second one will be about GGA and third-order DFPT. So as you probably all know, the meta-GGA is just in the middle of the DFT Jacob's ladder between ERF and EVM. And it has the advantage of having a low computational cost, but it is not negligible. It is not negligible. And also to introduce a bit of non-locality in the description of exchange correlation. And as you know also, in such functionals, meta-GGA functionals, the energy depends on the density, the gradient, and possibly on the Laplacian of the density, and possibly of the kinetic energy density. Usually in exchange correlation functional, it's exclusive. I mean, it's Laplacian or kinetic energy density. They are very rare functionals that introduce both. But okay, so in that work, we have considered both. And the kinetic energy density is simply defined as one function that integrates to the kinetic energy. This is not a unique function, simply because the integration of the Laplacian of the density is zero in finite or periodic systems. So every function different from another with the Laplacian of the density can be a kinetic energy density function, So still a reminder, the Hamiltonian in meta-GGA, in black you have the GGA Hamiltonian, so kinetic, local term, and also the GGA term, the divergence of something depending on the gradient and the density. And in red, you have the new term in meta-GGA. You have a term depending on the Laplacian of the derivative of the functional with respect to the Laplacian of the density. You have the kinetic energy density somewhere, and you have a non-local term there that applies directly to the wave functions. In terms of energy, there is almost nothing to do. As you can see, you just have to add an additional integral in your energy formula, and you get the energy in meta-GGA. So in a plane wave code as Habinit, what is the work? What is the why it is a bit non-negligible, and why it can be numerically unstable? First, when you want to apply this divergence of something depending on the gradient of the wave function, I don't go into details, but you have to apply a double FFT. An FFT and a backward FFT, like for the local potential, as you know, but you have to do that per each direction of the gradient. And if you want, on the other side, if you want to add the contribution of the Laplacian of the density, you have to compute the Laplacian. And again, the Laplacian is computed in a reciprocal space applying a double FFT, but it's a single double FFT. I mean, it's on the density. This one is two direction on each two FFTs per direction per wave function. So this one can be costly. And also, of course, it can be numerically unstable. So for that reason, we have very carefully checked the implementation. And to check the implementation, you don't need you don't have to do only a comparison with other codes. You have to check internally the implementation of that. And we, for that, we take advantage of this famous integration by parts formula that can connect the Laplacian of a wave function and the gradient of a wave function. And in between, you have an integral over the boundary, which is zero in our case. It is zero for the plane wave term for periodic system, because the boundary vector is symmetric. So at the end, you got zero. And it is zero for the PAW terms. I will come back on that just after, because on the boundary, the PAW terms are zero themselves. So at the end, you can connect the Laplacian to the gradient of the density. How can you do use that for tests? But you can connect the Laplacian used in meta GGA functionals to the gradient used in GGA functional. So you can imagine fake functionals, meta GGA and GGA, and you can run Abinit using GGA, you can run Abinit using meta GGA, and both should compare. And this is very convenient. Because we hope that the GGA implementation in Abinit is validated. There is another test which is classical but you can imagine to change the kinetic energy of your system by changing the effective mass of the electron, and introducing this new effective mass in a functional using the kinetic energy density. I don't want to go into detail, but you can construct a meta GGA functional having exactly the same total energy than a LDA functional. So we have done that, we have checked, and everything is consistent, and we can, at least internally, the tests are okay. I have two slides about PAW. This is not a new work. This has been implemented in the VASP code in the beginning of the 2010s years. So I don't want to recall what is PAW there. This is the usual scheme for PAW. You have the plane wave terms plus the additional on-site terms. You have several quantity to compute, an Hamiltonian, an intensity of the non-local potential, and you have several density to compute using this PAW occupancy matrix. That's not the point here. What I want to show you is that in meta GGA, you have new contribution to the intensity of the non-local term due to the kinetic energy density. And you see you have the derivatives of the basis function involved in that term. And also you have to compute the on-site kinetic energy density using the standard formula. And to do that, you develop that kinetic energy density over spherical harmonics, and you have spherical moment to compute. And what is important is to note that you have to implement new integrals involving spherical harmonics and their derivatives. That's it. And the classical implementation without meta GGA is to use Gaunt coefficient integral of three spherical harmonics, but for meta GGA, you have new integrals. Okay, so it has been done in Abinit. We have checked internally everything. We have corrected the first errors. I want to just to focus on how to use that in Abinit. You have to use a GGA pseudo potential file. And if you want to use non-conserving pseudo potential, it is not possible. You can do that at present, but without core correction. And from my knowledge, there is no non-conserving pseudo potential providing the core kinetic energy density, at least in the set of pseudo potential readable by Abinit. For PAW, it's different. You can use a pseudo potential from the GTH table. And soon, it is not in the present table, but very soon there will be the core kinetic energy density in the table. And very soon, AtomPo will be able to produce, we hope, meta GGO data sets. And Nathalie will speak about that just after my talk. And you just have to put a meta GGA value for IXC in your input file of Abinit. it's not very ergonomic. You know that because you are, the value is from libxc and has to be negative. So I have put that several examples. For scan is -263267. For R2 scan is -497498. We definitely have to find something more user-friendly to help user to make MetaGGA computations. You no more need to use a UScadon input parameter. It's automatically set. You just have to use it to output the kinetic energy density. And note that R2Scan is only available in libxc 5.1. And it will be soon available in the official version. And I mean, it's available in private version. But we are waiting for the stabilization of libxc about in its 5 version. OK, if you want to run MetaGGA, you have to increase the FFT grid size a bit because of the numerous FFT you have to compute. I showed that before. So be careful, make the convergency test with respect to the NGFFT and NGFFT-DG input parameter. There is a paper from Miao and Kanai showing that MetaGGA needs more FFT point grids than GGA. I don't want to go into details, but it's a known fact. If you want to use kinetic energy density based XA functional, you require more CPU time because of these additional FFTs. If you want to use a Laplacian based XA functional, the additional time CPU time is invisible. The Laplacian does not take time to be to compute it. Of course, we have checked with respect to published internally, as I explained, but also with respect to published quantities, we are happy with that because the pseudo potential are not exactly the same. We don't know how converged are the results of the literature, but apparently we have the same value as the literature, and we have computed your own. We have applied. We have used our own implementation of PAW plus MetaGGA. This is an example of a superhydride of manganese, and this will be part of the talk of Jean-Baptiste Charot tomorrow, if I remember correctly. So we were interested in the gap because these materials are possibly super. Conductors. So the gap is very important. So we have checked that MetaGGA doesn't open the gap too much. Okay, and last part of this section of about MetaGGA, we have implemented forces and stress tensor. For forces, the work was very light. You have just to add the contribution of the core kinetic energy density, the pseudo one, exactly like for the core density. And so it was very simple to implement because we call the same routine as for the core density, but using the kinetic energy density, okay. For the stress sensor, the work was different. I found no article describing how to implement the stress tensor in MetaGGA. I checked in two codes, having PAW and MetaGGA. I let you imagine which code. And I found that they compute that with the finite differences. It's possibly it exists in other code, but in the ones I know not. So we have the derivate, the formula. It's a bit tricky, but everything was explained by D'Acosto in Resta for the GGA. So we have applied that, and we have the version of the stress tensor. I have three slides, François, on the second part. No, more than three, but they are not shown. So I want also to make a point on further DFPT. Further DFPT is used, as you probably know, when you want to compute, for example, Raman intensities, and you have to compute such third-order derivatives of the energy. And so you need several derivatives of integrals giving the energy, first order, second order, third orders. And these ones are not so simple to compute. And just want to notice that for the valence part, you need only the order n derivative, but for the core part, you need the 2n plus 1 order derivative. It's the famous 2n plus 1 theorem. So let's start simple. In LDA, everything is simple. First order, second order, third order. You have to implement these kernels of the exchange correlation. And of course, it's implemented in Abinit. Okay, let's now add GGA and let's look at the first order. The second order, it becomes more complicated and because of this expression of the potential in GGA. But it is implemented in Abinit still. Okay, and now let's compute the third order of the energy, and then you got this much more complicated. The implementation, I must say, is not finished, but we are working on it, and it will be available, we hope, in a future version. So okay, in Abinit we use a more structured formula, keeping on one side ground terms depending only on the wave functions, ground state wave functions, and including them in a formula using derivative of the density. Okay, that's it. That's what we try to implement. We try to implement the spin polarized version. And this is the formula. And okay, and I hope you will find the error on the 10th slide. So it's not complicated. You just have to be careful and rigorous on your formula. You just have to derivate. So we are currently trying to implement this in Abinit to get the third order. And we can do that thanks to LIDIC-C5, which provides all the derivatives we need at third order. I must say that there is a conversion between Abinit and LIDIC-C, which is needed because we don't formulate exactly the same object. We don't have exactly the same object in the two, but of course it has been done. And I'm sorry, Luca, I will not have time to go into details in that part of the work in your slides, but we have to check that. We have implemented in Abinit a check procedure for the exchange correlation because it was not possible to make that manually and try to debug every term. So we have implemented in Abinit a way to debug a derivative of the exchange correlation integrals in Abinit. And Luca developed a tool using fictive densities with the analytical formula, and he compared the derivative, the analytical derivative of this density with respect to finite differences. And he has implemented that in a tool which has been included in the test suite. Currently, 18 tests have been added to the test suite, and you can compare and check your exchange correlation integrals in for all the derivative degrees. And that's it, François. Okay, just to mention that next to come is the GA third order. It is not merged into Abinit. Of course, once we have developed the third order DFPT in the MetaGGA in Abinit, we imagine to have the second order one.
So, okay, thank you, Marc.
To come.
There is a question from Camillo. Are the derivatives of the gradient versus the density currently available? Not completely, if I have well understood.
The derivative of the gradient? Which gradient? Versus
Camillo,
the density.
Do you want
I don't understand the question.
Yes. I mean the derivatives of the gradient of the density with respect to the density, to the electronic density.
In the DFPT implementation, we use the derivative of the density. Okay, and this derivative of the density and also the derivative of the gradient. Yes. To answer to your question, I hope the answer is yes. We have the derivative of the gradient. Yes. But it was done. It was done for the DGA part, huh, you know. I mean, for the DGA. Okay. You need the derivative of the gradient to in the formula.
Okay, but the derivative with respect to the spatial coordinates or the derivative with respect to the electronic density?
Ha! With respect to the spatial coordinate, it's the gradient, okay? And you can derive this gradient with respect to the perturbation you are considering.
Okay.
Not with respect to the density.
That's what we use. Okay, I'm asking this question because in the van der Waals non-local potential, this kind of derivatives appear. And for example, in Siesta, what they have done to calculate this kind of derivatives is a finite differences approach. But I was wondering if in Avinid we can deal with
the
that.
The derivative of the gradient, of yes. the spatial gradient with respect to the density?
Yes.
I think the formula should not be complicated and we should be able to use part of the implementation.
Oh, okay. Nice.
I think.
Okay. I would like to contact you later because this is an important step in this potential, non-local potential.